Students, good morning students. The today's chemical kinetics part 3. Today's concept is the temperature dependence of rate of reaction. You know that the temperature is also one of the factor which affects the rate of reaction. The temperature is increases, the rate of reaction is also increases. Now the concept is the temperature dependence of rate of reaction. The rate of reaction or the rate constant almost double for every 10 degree rise in temperature. The temperature is increases, the rate of reaction is also increases. So here the rate of reaction or the rate constant becomes almost double for every 10 degree rise in temperature. For example, if the temperature is increases from 0 to what? When the temperature is increases from what? 0 to what? 50 degree Celsius. So 0 to 50, total how many tens are there? N is equals to 5. So how many times the rate is increases? So we can calculate it by using equation or the formula 2 raised to n. So this is what? 2 raised to 5. What is this 2 raised to 5? 2 into 2 into 2, and this is what? 2. So 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8, 8 2's are 16, 16 2's are 32 times the rate is what? Or the rate constant is what? Increases. When the temperature is increases from 0 degree Celsius to what? 50 degree Celsius. So the number of tens increased is 5. So 2 raised to n equal to 2 raised to 5. 2 raised to 5 is nothing but a 32 times the rate of reaction is what? Increases. So similarly the temperature of a reaction increases from 10 degree Celsius to what? 10 degree Celsius to what? 100 degree Celsius. So 10 to 100, so how many tens are here? Total 9 tens. So how many times the rate is increases? 2 to the power of 9. So 2 to the power of 9 is nothing but a, so it increases by how many times? It increases by what? 512 times. So this is the temperature dependence of what? The rate of what? Reaction. And now I can discuss here the temperature coefficient. This is the very important temperature coefficient. What is this temperature coefficient? The temperature coefficient is nothing but a, the rate constant at a given temperature. It is the ratio of the rate constant at a given temperature to the rate constant at a 10 degree lower temperature. It is equals to what? 2 or what? It is equals to 2 or 3. It is called what? A temperature coefficient. The temperature coefficient is nothing but a ratio of the ratio of rate constant. Rate constant. It is the ratio of rate constant at two temperature, at two different temperature, differ by 10 degree. Differ by what? 10 degree Celsius. So it is called what? Temperature coefficient. In the examination, what is the temperature coefficient? The temperature coefficient is the ratio of the rate constant at a given temperature to the rate constant at a 10 degree lower temperature. It is called what? A temperature coefficient. Or it is the ratio of what? The rate constant at two different temperature, they are differ by what? 10 degree Celsius is called what? A temperature coefficient. Yes, the temperature coefficient is what? The temperature coefficient is the ratio of the rate constant at a given temperature. Given temperature means T plus 10 degree divided by what? The rate constant at 10 degree lower temperature. So it is called what? Temperature coefficient. How to define? It is the ratio of rate constant at two different temperature differ by 10 degree Celsius. So it is called what? Temperature coefficient. For example, For example, the reaction is carried out room temperature. For example, the room temperature is how much? For example, the reaction is carried out at room temperature. The room temperature T is equals to how much? It is what? 27 degrees Celsius. And what is the T plus 10? So T 27 plus what? 10 is equals to what? 37 degrees Celsius. And same the rate constant at 10 degree lower temperature, that is called what? 27 degrees Celsius. So one reaction is carried out at 27 plus 10 degree, it is what? 37 degree. And one rate constant at 27 degree, and the ratio of these two, so we can get what? We can get what? Double. This is nothing but the temperature coefficient of what? Reaction. The temperature dependence of the rate of reaction is accurately explained by the Arrhenius equation. K is equal to A into e to the power of what? EA divided by what? RT. The temperature dependence of rate of reaction is explained by what? The Arrhenius equation K is equals to A into e to the power of what? Minus EA divided by RT. Where K is called what? Rate constant. Rate constant. And A is called what, everybody? Arrhenius factor. And this EA is called what here? EA is what? Activation energy. Later I will discuss what is meant by activation. But first now you know that EA is called what? Activation energy. And here E to the power of minus EA divided by RT. So it indicates what? The fraction of molecule. Have the kinetic energy is equal or greater than what? Greater than activation energy. The temperature dependence of the rate of reaction is accurately explained by what? That is the Arrhenius equation. This is called what? Arrhenius equation. K is equals to A into e to the power of minus A divided by RT. K is called rate constant. A is called Arrhenius factor. Or what is Arrhenius factor? The number of collision per second. And A is called what? Activation energy. And e to the power of minus A divided by RT, this is nothing but the fraction of molecule. How the kinetic energy is equal to or the greater than what? EA. So now, increasing temperature or lower activation energy results what? Increase in rate of reaction. So it means the temperature what is the temperature? For every 10 degree rise in temperature, the rate of reaction is double. So here, when the temperature is increases and the lowers this activation energy, or it results what? It results what? Increase in rate of what? Reaction. According to Arrhenius equation, so this is what? H2 gas plus of what? I2 gas, it gives rise to what? 2HI. See here. So according to Arrhenius, a molecule of hydrogen is collide. The molecule of hydrogen collide with molecule of iodine. So leads to what? Leads to unstable intermediate. This unstable intermediate is called what? Is called activated complex. Okay. So according to Arrhenius, the molecule of hydrogen is collide with what? The molecule of iodine. This results or it leads to what? Unstable intermediate. This unstable intermediate is called what? Is called what? Activated complex. And it leaves what? So short period, okay, it gives what? The short period. So after that, so it gives what? After that it gives what? Product. After that it gives product, that is what? 2HI. So the energy is required, the energy is required to form intermediate is called activation energy. So iodine, hydrogen collides with iodine, it leads to what? Unstable intermediate. This, it is very short period, and it gives what? Product. And this intermediate, this is called unstable intermediate, is called what? Activated complex. What is the, so the energy, what is the activation energy? The energy is required to form intermediate. That intermediate is called what? Activated complex, is called what? Activation energy. So according to this graphical method, so along the y-axis, this is what? Potential energy. Along x-axis is what? Reaction coordinate. So the molecule of H2 and the molecule of I2 both are collide and leads what were at intermediate state. That intermediate state is called what? Activated complex. The energy is required to form what? Activated complex. So that is called what? That is called what? Activation energy. This is called what? Activation energy. And now it gives what? Finally it gives what? The product. This is what? 2HI. Yes. Next, calculation of activation energy. So the first, what is the Arrhenius equation? Arrhenius equation. This is the Arrhenius equation. What is this Arrhenius equation? K is equals to A e to the power of Ea divided by RT. This is the equation number 1. Now, taking log on both side. Yes. So, ln of K is equals to ln of what? A e to the power of what? Ea divided by RT. Now, ln of what? K is equals to, you know that, log A into B. Log A plus log B. Similarly, ln of A into e to the power of Ea divided by RT. So, this is ln A plus of what? Ln of what? Minus of Ea divided by what? RT. Yes, ln of what? K is equals to ln of what? A. Log A to the power of X. Log A to the power of X. X log A. So here ln E to the power of minus of Ea divided by RT is nothing but a minus of Ea divided by RT. This is ln of what? E. Now ln of what? K is equals to what? Ln of A plus minus minus. This is Ea divided by what? RT. Ln log e to the log e is equals to what? 1. So similarly, ln e is equals to 1. Now ln of what? K is equals to ln of what? A minus of Ea divided by RT. Now you have to change ln into what? Log. You have to multiply with what? 2.303. Now 2.303, this is ln changes to what? Log. Yes, this is what? Same. 2.303, this is what? Log of A minus of Ea divided by minus Ea divided by RT. This is what, everybody? Equation number 2. Divide equation 2 by what? 2.303. By dividing, so we can get log of K is equals to log of what? A minus of Ea divided by what? 2.303 RT. or log of what k is equals to minus of Ea divided by what 2.303 RT plus of what log A. So this is the next, this equation is in the form of what? This equation is of form, this equation is of form what? Y is equals to what? Y is equals to mx plus c. This equation is of form y is equal to mx plus c is a nothing but a equation of what? Straight line. Suppose if you want to calculate the calculation of activation energy by what? Graphical method. Now if you want to calculate the activation energy by graphical method, so you have to use this equation. You have to use this equation, log k is equals to minus of Ea divided by 2.303 RT plus of log A. You take this what? You take this is S. This is what the graph. So along y axis, you take the value of what? You take the value of what? Log k. Along x axis, you have to take what? The temperature. Log k is called what? Y. So m is nothing but a slope minus Ea divided by 2.303 R, and 1 by T is nothing but a X, C is called what? Intercept. You take the log K values along Y axis and the 1 by T is along what? X axis. So we can get what? Straight line. So this is called what, everybody? This is called intercept. This intercept is nothing but a log of A. Then you have to calculate slope. What is the slope? Slope is equals to Ea divided by what? Ea divided by 2.303 R. So once you get what slope, what is the activation energy? Activation energy is equals to slope into 2.303 into what? R. So this is called what? The calculation of what? Activation energy by what? Graphical method. So here, so you know that this log k is equals to minus of Ea divided by 2.303 RT plus log A. This is the equation of straight line. Y is equal to mx plus c. Y is nothing but a log k. X is nothing but a 1 by t. And so we can get what? The straight line. Well, after getting the straight line, slope is equals to what? Ea divided by 2.303 R. So Ea is equals to, you multiply slope into 2.303 into R. So we can get what? We can get activation energy by what? Graphical method. Now the calculation of activation energy by graphical method is over. Log k is equals to minus of Ea divided by 2.303 RT plus of what? Log A. So now the calculation of activation energy by what? The formula method. Is what, everybody? Formula method. So what is this formula method? Yes. The calculation of what? Activation energy at two different temperature. The calculation of what? Activation energy at two different temperature. Yes. At two different temperature. Yes. First, at temperature T1, what is the Arrhenius equation? Log of what? K1 is equals to minus of what? Ea divided by 2.303 R RT, means RT1 plus of what? Log of what? A. This is the equation number 1. Next, at temperature T2, what is the expression? Log of what? K2 is equals to minus of Ea divided by 2.303 R T2 plus of what? Plus of what? Log A. This is the equation number 2. Next is what here? Subtract equation 2 minus 1. If you subtract equation 2 minus 1, so here log A will be cancelled. Now I can take here log of what? K2 minus of log of what? K1 is equals to what anybody? Log K2. It is got as minus of what EA divided by 2.303 R. This is what T2 plus of what anybody? Log A minus of what? Minus of S. EA divided by 2.303 R T1. This is what? Plus of what? Plus of what? Log A. Now expression. Log K2 by K1. Log A by B is nothing but a log K2 by K1. Now it is minus of EA divided by 2.303 R2 plus of what? Log A minus of what anybody? 2.303 R. This is T1. Plus minus minus, this is what? Log A. Plus log A minus log A cancel. Or the expression log of what? K2 by K1 is equal, which is the common factor? The common factor is EA. EA is the common factor. 2.303 R. This is what anybody? 1 divided by T1 minus of what? 1 divided by T2 or log of what? Log of what? K2 divided by K1 is equals to EA divided by 2.303 R. Now the expression is T2 minus of T1 divided by T1 T2. So this is the expression for the calculation of what? Activation energy at two temperature, that is T1 and T2. This is the expression for the calculation of activation energy at two different temperature, that is T1 and T2. This expression is very important for the annual examination point of view. So calculate the activation energy at two different temperature. Okay, so this is for the calculation of activation energy by graphical method. Then I can go for what? Some numericals or the problems is based on what? This formula method and also graphical method. Yes, now the problems based on what? Activation energy. It is also very important for annual examination point of view. The rate of reaction is double when the temperature is increases from 300 Kelvin to what? 310 Kelvin. So calculate the activation energy. Already we know that for every 10 degree rise in temperature, the rate of reaction is what? Double. Now the solution. Now what is the expression? Log of what? K2 divided by what? K1. Log of K2 divided by what? K1 is equals to what? EA divided by 2.303 R, and this is what? T2 minus of T1. This is what? T1 T2. So this is the expression. For the rate of reaction is a double. Double means for every 10 degree rise in temperature. So K2 by K1 is equals to 2. And what R value? It is a universal gas constant, 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. This is the okay. What is the initial, what is the temperature? Temperature is 300 Kelvin and the second temperature is 310 Kelvin. The difference is 10. 10 means what? The rate of reaction is double. Then you have to calculate. The question mark is activation energy. Yes, you have to substitute log of K2 by K2. Yes, EA. Yes. Next is anybody? Yes. What is this T2? T2 is nothing but a 310 minus of 300. What is it? This is 2.303. What is the R value? 8.314. What is the temperature? T1, 300 into 310. You know that what is the log 2? Log 2, what is the characteristic? Characteristic is 0. Log 2. Log 2 means log 20, 0 column. 3010. EA, 310, this is what? 10. Now it is what? 2.303 into 8.314 into 300 into 310. This is a into what anybody? Into what? 310. Now what you have to find out? Activation energy. So now how to find out activation? Activation energy is equal to, you make cross multiplication, 0.3010 into 2.303 into 8.314 into 300 into 310 divided by what? Divided by 10. Now EA is equals to what? Activation energy. And you have to multiply 0.3010 into 2.303 into 8.314 into 300 into 310. So we can get here divided by 10. So we can get the answer is 53. Next is what? 59.598.5. This is what? Joule per mole. This is a joule. Suppose if you get answer in kilojoule, you have to move this point 10 raised to 1, 10 raised to 2, 10 raised to 3. 53.59. 10 raised to 3 is nothing but a kilojoule per mole. So this is the calculation of what? Calculation of what? Activation energy. Yes, students, second problem. The rate of reaction is quadruples when temperature changes from 293 to 313 Kelvin. What is the difference? Difference is 20. For the difference is 10, the rate of reaction is double. But here the difference is what? 20 means what? Automatically it is what? 4 times. 4 times is nothing but a quadruples. Yes, what is the expression? Solution. What is the expression? Log of what? K2 divided by K1 is equals to sec EA divided by 2.303 R. Expression is what? T2 minus of T1 divided by T1 T2. This is the expression. So for every 10 degree rise in temperature, the rate of reaction is what? Double. But here the difference is what? 20. It means what? 4 times. 4 times is nothing but a quadruples. So now I can take K2 by K1. K2 by K1 is equals to 4. And what is the R value? You know that already. 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. And what is the temperature T1? Temperature T1 is equals to 293 Kelvin. What is the temperature T2? Temperature T2 is nothing but a 313 Kelvin. What is the equation? What you have to find out? How to find out what activation energy? Yes, you have to substitute. Log of K2 by K1 is 4. Now EA is equals to what is T2? 293 divided by 2.303 R is 8.314. What is the T1? T1 is equals to 293. What is T2? T2 is equals to 313. What is log 4? What is the characteristic? One digit means 0 point. Log 4. Log 4 means log 40. Log 40 0 column is 6021 is equals to EA. It is how much? It is the 20. Now this is 2.303, 8.314, or it is equals to 293, into 293 into 313. Now, how to calculate activation energy? You take cross multiplication, 0.6021, 2.303, 8.314 into 293 into 313 divided by what? Divided by 20. So now activation energy, you have to multiply 0.6021 into 2.303 into 8.314 into 293 into 313. So we can get 127.602 divided by what? 20. So what is the activation energy? So now you have to divide 1259937.602 divided by 20. So we can get 52863.3. This is what? The joule per mole. This is the answer. Suppose if you get the answer in kilojoule, the point moves here 10 raised to 1, 10 raised to 2, 10 raised to 3, 52.86, 10 raised to 3 is nothing but a kilo. This is the kilojoule per mole. So this is the very important problem for our annual examination point of view. And this question is also asked in the year 2019. So calculate the rate of reaction is quadruples when the temperature changes from 293 to 313 Kelvin. Okay. Yes, now third problem. The rate constant of a reaction at 500 Kelvin and 700 Kelvin are 0.02 per second and 0.07 per second. Calculate EA and A. But here K2 by K1 is not given directly. They given separate and how to divide it K2 by K1. Yes, solution. The solution, now I can take log of K2 by K1 is equals to EA divided by 2.303 R T2 minus of T1 divided by T1 T2 is. What is the K1? K1 is equals to 0.02 per second. What is K2? K2 is equals to 0.07 per second. Already you know that R is 8.314 joule per Kelvin. So I think it is not necessary to write. But anyhow, I can write R is equals to 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. Yes, what is the temperature? Temperature T1 500 K and temperature T2 is 700 K. First you have to find out activation energy first. Then you go for A. So now I can take here log of, what is the K2? 0.07 divided by 0.02 is equals to EA. Now 2.303 R is equals to 8.314 into T2 is how much? 700 minus 200 is equals to, this is what anybody, sorry, not 200, it is 500 is equal, next it is what, 500 into what? 500 into 700. Yes, log 0.07 divided by 0.02, so we can get log 3.5 is equals to EA. What is 700 minus 500 is equals to 200. Now it is 2.303 into 8.314 into 500 into what? 700. This is 700. Yes. Now, what is this log 3.5? So 3.5, what is the characteristic? Characteristic is 0. Log 35, you see log 35, 0 column. It is how much? 5441. Yes. Now is equals to what? EA into 200 divided by 2.303 into 8.314 into 500 into what? 700. Now what you have to find out? Activation energy. Activation energy is equals to cross multiplication 0.441 into, yes, 2.303 into 8.314 into 500 into 700 divided by 200. Now the activation energy EA is equals to, yes, you have to multiply 0.441 into 2.303 into 8.314 into 500 into 700, so we can get 36 46 285.98 divided by what? 200. So what is the activation energy? Activation energy EA is equals to 18,231.4 joule per mole. So this is the calculation of activation energy at two different temperature, 400 Kelvin and 700 Kelvin. Then so we can go for Arrhenius factor A. Already the activation is over. Now is what? A. So now in the equation, what is the equation? Log of K is equals to minus of what? Ea divided by 2.303 RT plus of what? Log of what? A. Yes. So K values are 2, 0.02 and 0.07. Anyone you have to take? Yes, I can take log of 0.02. Yes. Minus activation energy, already we have found. What is the activation energy? 18231.4. Yes. 2.303 R value is 8.314. What is the temperature? 500. Plus of what? Log A. Log A is the question. So you know that 0.02. What is the bar? Bar 2. Bar 2 is nothing but a minus 2 plus 0. Log 2 is what? 3010 is equals to minus 18231.4. Now you have to multiply 2.303 into 8.314 into 500. So we can get 9573.571 plus of what? Plus of what? Log A. Plus of what? Log A. Yes. Now minus 2 plus 0.3010, it is minus of 1.699. It is 1.699. And you divide 1.231.4 divided by 9573.571. So we can get minus of 1.904 plus of what? Plus of what? Log of what? A. Now this come this side. This is what? 1904 minus of 1.699 is equals to what? Is equals to what? Log A. Yes, now log A is equals to 1.904 minus 1.699, it is equals to how much? It is equals to 0.205. A is equals to NT log. A is equals to NT log of 0.205. Yes, you go for NT log. In NT log, you see 0.20. Fifth column, 0.20 of fifth column, so we can get 1603. NT log of 0.25 is what? 1603. So this is 0 plus 1 after 1, you have to put what digit? This is the Arrhenius factor or the number of collision per second, or it is also called free exponential factor. This is also called free exponential factor or Arrhenius factor. Yes, you go through this. Write down. Composition of S2O2 is given by the following equation. Log K is equals to 14.34 minus of 1.25 into 10 to the power of what? 4 divided by what? T. And the solution. Yes, first you have to write down Arrhenius equation. What is Arrhenius equation? Log of K is equals to minus of what? Ea divided by 2.303 RT plus of what? Log A. So this is the equation number 1. This equation number 1 is called what? Arrhenius equation. And compare the given equation. Compare the given equation, log of what? K minus of what? 125 into 10 to the power of 4 divided by T plus of what? Anybody? Plus of what? Log of what? 14.34. So this is the Arrhenius equation. Log K is equals to minus Ea divided by 2.303 RT plus of log A. and the compare the given equation. Given equation is what? Log k is equals to minus of 1.25 into 10 to the power of 4 divided by t plus of what? Log of what? 14.34 with equation 1. Yes. Now log k is common. Now you have to find out what activation energy, and you have to compare this equation 1 and equation 2. So minus of Ea divided by 2.303 RT is equals to minus of 1.25 into 10 to the power of 4 divided by what? T. So minus minus get cancelled and TT gets cancelled. So what is the remaining? You have to find out activation energy. Activation energy is equal to cross multiplication 2.303 into R. Already the TT is what? Cancelled. Is equals to what? 2.5 into 10 to the power of what? 4. Yes, you have to find out activation energy is equals to 2.303. What is the R value? 8.314 into 1.25 into 10 to the power of what? 4. So we can get the activation energy. A is equals to 230. It is what? 239.34 kilojoule per mole. This is the kilojoule per mole. Suppose if you want to calculate what? Arrhenius factor. And you have to compare this is what? Log A is equals to what for A? Log A is equals to log 14.34. So we can get what? Similarly, Arrhenius factor. Okay, this much is sufficient to calculate what? Activation energy. Okay. So these are the total four problems is based on what? Activation energy. Okay. Thank you.